Now I'd like to present the lecture about letter of apology. In this lesson, we're going to cover five aspects. First of all, we're going to learn some features. This one will help you to understand how to write the letter of apology well. And then we are going to look at the sample tasks and the sample answer. You can learn more from the sample answer. You can write much better. We also look at the paragraph length, and then we are going to learn the useful expression for writing letter of apology. We also practice and look at the assignment. The purpose for writing letter of apology is to apologize for our mistake or failure. And in most cases, we write to respond to a letter of complaint. In order to write such letter, you need to cover the following main point. As the name of letter of apology suggests, we need to express an apology. And then we're going to explain the reason for the problem, for the inconvenience caused to our recipient. And we should ensure that the situation can be or will be resolved or improved. And you'd better offer some compensation. Okay, so remember, please cover the four main points of the letter. Some more features that you should know is the tech organization. One should be covered in separate paragraph, and you need to give example in your body paragraph. And as for writing sign, when you write to your close friend or your relative, you can use informal style. However, in most letter, you write the formal style and you expect the polite tone. Because the formal style will make your letter sound more sincere. Many of you may wonder what a writing task looks like. Now, you look at this task. As a manager of a car rental company, you have received a letter of complaint about a problem with the car you rent to a customer that causes dissatisfaction to him or her. Write a suitable letter of apology. Here you can see, this letter should be a complaint letter, and you should focus on the problem with the car that you rent. And you can see the key word for this car letter is write a letter of apology. Sometimes they may ask you, write a letter apologizing for your failure, apologizing for your mistake, so they can use the verb form. Alright? And if you look at this letter, you can see this is the formal letter of apology. We begin with the greeting. And in the first body paragraph, you can see they write directly. In response to your letter, blah, blah, blah. I would like to begin by giving my sincere apologize for blah, blah. And then in paragraph 2, 3, they explain why the problem occurs and how they can deal with that. And paragraph 4, you can see the first sentence. This is truly a regrettable occurrence. This one also indicates an apology. And then, please allow me to offer you, blah, blah, blah. This is the offer of compensation. When you're writing business letter, you should also learn some useful expressions such as, I hope this offer will make up for and will restore your confidence in our company. And you can see they emphasize the apology again before they finish with the ending, with the closing remark, yours sincerely. Now we should spend some time to look at paragraph length. like most letter, the first paragraph should be to state the reason or the purpose for writing. Paragraph 2 and 3, it depends on the situation, so you can separate into a different paragraph. You express your apologies and the explanation. And paragraph 3 or 4 suggests improvements or compensation. And of course, don't forget to have a proper or appropriate closing remarks. And remember to sign your name. So whatever you write, please remember that in business letter, your letter should be at least 4 paragraphs. And now, the most important part that you should learn is the useful impressions. You can start your letter of apology with, I'm writing to apologize for, or I'm writing to affirm my apologies for. You can also use, I must or I would like to apologize for blah blah blah. Take example, I'm writing to apologize for the inconvenience that you experienced with the broken car we ran to you on the 20th of July. If you look at the example, you can see they write very sharp, very clear, and it should be specific with the name of the problem, that is the inconvenience with the broken car. So what happened to this car? It is a broken car. Not the high price or the poor service. And what day? Don't write last week. Some days ago. When is some days ago? Make your writing sound specific. And also, if you have written the expression, please underline the preposition. Apologize for something, not about something. Okay? This is something that you begin the letter. And in the main part, when you express your apology, you can use some questions such as, I apologize most sincerely for, I must apologize for, I offer you my sincere apologies for, please accept my sincere or profuse apologies for blah blah blah. And informal situation, I or we deeply regret or sorry. In my lecture, you can also see this example. I apologize most sincerely for the delay in the delivery of the laptops you ordered from us on September the 21st. And I think, besides the different expression, you can learn as many expression for the problem as possible. When you are doing something late, you know how to write the late delivery of something. As important part of the letter, you can give explanation or reason for your mistakes or failure. You can use some phrase with to be due to, owing to, because of, or very formal. The reason for this was that I'd like to talk more about the use of this. Sometimes you're correct, you're okay, but sometimes you may have problem with if you use too many this and this and this. If your reason is close to your apology, you can use this. However, if you write in separate paragraph, in another paragraph, you should not use this, but you use this late delay, this broken car, this poor service. So you have to use a noun phrase after this to make sure and make it clear what problem is it. In order to make amends or suggest to make amends or suggest conversation, you can use please allow me to offer blah 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 as compensation for, or I insist on to make up for your loss or your inconvenience. You can write, I'm pleased to inform you that we are prepared to. Let's imagine that you offer $100 as compensation. So your sentence can say, please allow me to offer you $100 as compensation for the cost of your train ticket. Different type of letter contain different preparation for closing. So the closing remarks for this cover letter can be something like, I hope this offer will make up for the inconvenience caused. You can say, or I hope that my apology will be accepted. You can use some verb like forgive or overlook. I hope that you can forgive this regrettable error or overlook. When you are doing this in it, and of course, sometimes we can cause some inconvenience to our partner or our customer. The thing is that you should reassure them, improve the situation, and you should indicate somewhere in your letter to keep your customer. So you write something so that you would not lose your customer. All right? So some expression such as to restore your confidence in our company, blah, blah, right? So you can say more about the good point of your company. What we have learned so far can help you to write successful letters of apology. And now, please have a look at the writing assignment. As a sales representative of a large manufacturing company, you have received several letters from a customer complaining about a long delay in the delivery of goods on order. Write a letter of apology to the customer explaining why the goods have been delivered and giving information concerning days and means of shipment of a new delivery. Remember to bring your complaint letter for the start press meeting for correction. When you are doing this task, please use the language feature to apply the writing style appropriately, and also try to use and vary the use of fashion that we have learned in this letter. Thank you for your attention. Do you have any question or comment? And of course, after you have done several practices in your material together with the lecture, if you want to ask me any questions, don't hesitate to ask.
I want to ask, is it the format of things that we have learned are using usually in the company? Because when I working in the company, I have written some kind of emails, and I thought it's a bit differently because nowadays we write shortly, as short as possible, and the paragraph is not much words like this, so
you should distinguish between writing email with letter. So the language of writing mails can be short, right? Can be informal, it's more informal. However, sometimes you may need to write apology letter. You write letter, it's different from mail. Mail is some kind of notes, right? Okay? And of course, when you have to bring your letter, it should look like this. But when you bring your email writing, it may look very informal. But it depends on the situation. For example, if it is just the exchange of information, So you can write the mail. But if the problem is serious, so you may write formal. Whatever email or letter, it should be formal because the problem is serious. Okay, and now we are going to do some